Hello, everyone. How are you all doing today? Hope you're all doing amazingly well. My name is Lex, and welcome back to Minecraft. We're in the park today. This is where our house used to be. Back when we first landed in this village and built our little shack, it was around, It was around this area here we had our shack. And obviously, the shack has been replaced by this nice little park here with a pond in the middle and the play area, which means that we now have to have a new place for the house. Well, the house is finished and built, so we're going to be looking around it today and checking out the house. Before we do that, I'm just going to read out a couple of questions. If you guys want your comments to be featured in the next video, leave a comment in the comment section below and I'll pick a couple at random and feature them in the next video. The first comment we got here is from Mr. Derpy that says, "Dude, you have like 100,000 subs and still less views than when you had way less subs. Still remember your old ticket builds." The reason for that is the subscriber thing goes up, but because I've not been putting out a lot of videos, YouTube doesn't really tell people all the time when I upload a video, because they don't think people want to watch me anymore, because they, because if I don't put a video out for a month, then YouTube will go, "Oh, he's not put a video out for the month. People haven't been watching him. Maybe they don't care about him anymore. We won't tell them when his new video comes out." It's just a really weird way that YouTube works. And it means that... Okay, that was scary. It does mean that when I upload videos, not everyone really gets told. So it's hard to say how many subscribers are actually active, because some of them might be active and want to see the videos, but YouTube doesn't tell them. So always try to make sure, if you want to get up-to-date information, by the way, on what I do, follow me on Twitter, @figure8. There will be a link in the description below where you can follow me on Twitter. That will be the place to go in order to find me. The next comment is from Joshua Duffy. It says, "LexTube, will you ever make more awesome Tekkit builds? Will you even do anything with Tekkit or just leave it alone?" The answer to that is I'm leaving it alone. Tekkit builds, in other words, any of that Let's Build stuff, is so difficult for me. I lost all the fun and enjoyment of doing that series, so I quit it. It wasn't fun for me anymore. I'd done what I needed to do. I would have liked to have done more, but I just really just, it just took a lot out of me to build these builds as much as you guys enjoyed them. So I've decided to keep my own sanity and quit. And that's why we're doing something new. That's why we're doing this. This is different. This is nice. Hopefully you guys are enjoying this. It's just something, oh, by the way, you might see it over there. That's a little teaser before we answer this last one. BJ Controllers says, "I have a question that has nothing to do with the channel, but do you know and like the band Dire Straits?" The answer is I know them, and no, I don't listen to their music. Actually, the one genre I don't really listen to is anything sort of rock-ish related. I don't really listen to that. I'm far more into things like R&B and hip-hop and electronic music, and also stuff like ballads and pop music. That's really my sort of thing. Don't really listen to that much rock, I'm afraid. I'm sorry for those of you that are into that sort of stuff. It's not really my sort of thing. So, right, this is our village. This is how far we've come. That building, we're not going to be checking out today. We're going to be checking that out another time. But our new house is over here. So this is the start. As you can see already, we've got a huge yellow flag inside of a fountain in our front garden. And here it is. This is our brand new house. And we've got a really nice entrance that goes up to it. So we've got these stepping stones here. I might tidy up this garden. It's a bit overgrown. We might mow the lawn. And I don't know. I might make a nice little flower patch. But I've already got these flowers in the hedges here. So I'm not too sure. I don't want to overdo it. We've also got a lot of flowers in these flower pots that are at the bottom of these windows over here. And we've got some more of these plants in the hedges and stuff like that on top, or on the front, or on the side of the building, just sort of hanging down there. So as we go up here, we've got some nice little lights on the side. We've got our doorbell. Love that. Ding dong. And we've got our letterbox. And of course, we've got this sign for our missing Cooper. He will turn up eventually. I've actually moved his kennel in the hopes that maybe it's because the house had moved that he had disappeared. So I'm leaving the kennel there in case he comes back. So this is what it looks like around the side. We've got some things here. We've got our broom. We've got a rake just to rake up all the stuff. Autumn's coming, so I just want to make sure that we don't have any sort of leaves on the ground or anything like that. And this is our nice little chill area around the back here with a watering can for our flowers. Now let's just actually go around the back. We've also got this little birdhouse on the side here. Got our kennel, got a nice little tree, got a nice picket fence going all the way around. And here is our back garden. And here you can see the house from the back as well, with some more flower pots, looking totally lovely. Let's actually just walk all the way around and then we go inside. So here it is from this side. A lot more roof on this side, as you can see. Still looking around. Lovely, lovely, jubbly. And back to the front again. So there's plenty more that's going to be built here. All of this lot will eventually have buildings in them, hopefully. So here we go. Let's actually go inside. So this is the downstairs area. Right here, we've got our thing where our hat rests and our keys. We've got some bookshelves, and there's the stairs upstairs. We'll check that out in a minute. Here is the living room. Got some more bookshelves. Got the TV up here on the table. Looks a bit unstable, but I'm sure it's fine. We've got a grandfather clock here, which doesn't move because the time right now in Minecraft is dead still. Time does not move, but it looks better that way, so that's why I do that. We have here, we've got a nice little coffee table, we've got our carpet, and we've got a very nice sofa that we can sit on. Very nice. And we've got a lamp as well, but it doesn't seem to light up. I don't know if I'm doing it wrong, if there was some way to light it up, but it doesn't really work as a light. Here we have a massive feast going on with this huge pig. We've got all of these on the dining room table, all these plates set up with our glasses, our forks, our spoons, our knives, our serviettes, and even we've got our little plate there with the knife for our little piece of bread or something like that. And look at the size of this pig. This is absolutely massive. Now, I'm going to include the main mod, which is for this, in the comment section, in the description below. It's called DecoCraft, I believe. It's what adds all of this sort of stuff, like the pig platter, which, by the way, can go in any sort of rotation. But we're not actually going to look at any specific mod, really, in this one. I just want to show you guys the house. So as we turn around here, firstly, we've got this really nice fish tank right there, which leads us on to the kitchen. We've got all this kitchen stuff. Now, I'm definitely going to be doing a video, guys, explaining how all of this stuff works. So get ready for that in the future. Here we've got our sink all filled up. We've got a, is that a blender, I think? We've got more kitchen cabinets up here. We've got a toaster. We've got a jam jar? A cookie jar, rather. We've got our cooker and stuff here. I'm pretty sure you can turn that on, maybe, but I don't know. Can't really seem to find out how. And our oven. And we've got a nice little thing so we can prepare our food. And then over the end here, we've got a bit of meat on a plate and a cake. Very nice indeed. Right, moving on to upstairs. Oh, by the way, there's something there, but it's not ready yet. So we'll check that out in another video. So here we go upstairs. And first of all, at the end of the landing, you can see a big mirror, which leads us on to the study area, where I've got a nice dartboard over here. I've got our computer, our printer, got some paper, got a Rubik's Cube. We've got a nice little plushie. I don't know if it's meant to be an alien or a creeper, like a miniature creeper. I don't really know. It doesn't have a creeper face, so it might just be a little slime alien thing. And of course, the radio, which does play music. It plays random music as well. There we go. Should we leave that on? I don't know. Maybe we... Let's just turn it off for now. Okay. Let's go outside. And as you can see, we've got our clothes hanging up here. This is a really nice sort of area for our stuff to hang and dry because it's tall, so we can get lots of wind. And here we have a really nice bird feeder right there, looking very nice. And of course, more plants around here just to make it look nice and green and pretty. And as you can see, that is our view of the mountain over there. We need a bit more draw distance to actually see the mountain properly, but it's a pretty nice view anyway, especially with that over there as well. Really nice area in between these two mountains right here. So here we go back inside. Oh, by the way, we've also got one of these outside. I love these things. These are from Red Power, or Red Power's, what, it Project Red, that's the one. I keep saying Red Power. I'm thinking like years back for Minecraft. That hasn't, Red Power doesn't, it's not even a thing anymore, is it? Project Red, of course. I really do love these. They look great. In fact, should I have that above the door? Above or to the side? Let me know in the comments, guys. What do you think is better? On the side or on the top? Or maybe on the right-hand side? Let me know in the comment section below. I'm going to leave it up the top for now. Okay, back in, get rid of our stuff, and move on to, we'll check that landing out in a minute. In here is the bathroom. We've got our toilet right here. We can press F for farts. Can't hear any farts. Oh, man, maybe that's broken. Okay, let's ignore that. We've got some towels hanging up here. We've got our shower, and our sink, which we need a water source for, which we can't really get because it's upstairs. And we've got our kitchen cabinet, or our bathroom cabinet rather, and some toilet roll. There's our shower. Nice. Nice. Turn that off. And a bath as well, which of course needs a water source that we don't have. But we can actually just use a water bucket. And, oh, not a lava bucket. Actually, I wonder, can we put a lava bucket in? I'm going to grab a block in case we have to quickly destroy it. Because I don't want to... Oh, okay, we can't really do anything. Okay, but let's fill that up with water. Nice. And some water in there as well. Why not? There we go. Looking pretty cool. So that is the bathroom. Oh, of course, we've also got some toilet roll there. Outside of here, we've got a little landing area, which has got our storage and just a nice little spare sofa. And this leads up to the attic, which is also, by the way, really nice view outside that window. But it's also the master bedroom. Look at this really nice, quaint area in the attic, looking lovely. So we've got this area here where we can prepare for the day. Don't really need to do much work. We always look the same, really. Don't really need to do anything there. And of course, we have a really nice four-poster bed. Really nice. And we can sleep, but we can't sleep right now because it's actually during the day. And really nice view outside the window too. And we've got some bedside cabinets as well, just to make this thing look pretty. And of course, a carpet. We've always got to have carpet, just to make, because there's wood and it's a bit cold, so the carpet made it look nice. And the red actually goes with the blue. How about that? And of course, some extra storage there. Most of this stuff is from our previous house that I've moved over, but we've not really used, such as the telescope. Should we put the telescope down? I've just thought, let's put that outside here. Let's go to here. And where's that going to position? Right, that's no good. We want it right here, like that. There we go. Nice. And then actually we can use that to look at that mountain over there. How about that? Brilliant. There we go, guys. That is the new house. Finished. This is our new base. We finally have a house. And maybe now that we have a house, Cooper might find his way back to his kennel. We don't know. But there we go, guys. Thank you ever so much for watching. And for sticking around with these videos, I know I don't do them as frequently as I would like. I can only apologize for that. But if you want more frequent videos by me, go check out my Figure 8 channel. That's where all my main stuff is right now. But this stuff, I like to take my time. I like to take my time building and planning things out. And that's why I can't really do stuff every single day. But there we go, guys. Thank you very much for watching. And I will see you all next time. Goodbye!